expressing myself in words has never been my forte. You know, my parents were worried because by the age of 3, I still hadn't said a word. I suppose I did talk eventually, but even then it was the bare minimum. I didn't really find my voice until the age of 13. And this is when I stumbled upon my first dance class. I discovered that I could voice something without having to struggle to find the right words. To dance, it was a sigh of relief. There was rhythm, there was texture to the movement. I could express myself 100% from fingers to toes. But although it did feel natural, it wasn't easy. We've all felt insecure. And for dance, I had to be in front of a mirror all day. And at a Russian ballet competition. And worst of all, I would brutally critique myself until all I saw were my flaws. You know, and I would go to auditions. And I just remember pouring with sweat, bleeding with bloody blistered toes, and just dreaming for that one contract that the company was providing. And I'd be amongst hundreds of dancers from China, from Russia, from Italy, from France, from Brazil. And one memorable year, I went through 24 auditions. And I was rejected 23 times. And I still love auditions. And an image that actually helped me in these auditions is ironically from the physics class. So these are my lovelies. I call them the Three Musketeers. I'm the new, naive, ignorant D'Artagnan. And we work with lasers for quantum optics. And how a laser works is it's this resin cavity, and with excited atoms in it. And so a photon comes in, and when it hits an excited atom, another photon is released. And so what's important is that there are mirrors on either ends of this cavity, and so that the photons can go through and bounce back and forth. And each time, it hits more and more excited atoms, releasing more and more photons. And so this energy exponentially grows back and forth. And so here on stage, I imagine that I've got a mirror on my chest. And so that the stage light shining on me, I then project to the audience. And you guys have an energy that I feed off of. And then I give back again with added energy. And this cycle goes on. And it's exactly like that energy and the light and the laser pattern. And I find that this giving that lightens us up, you know, it's a physical connection that is unique to live music, live performances, live talks. Right? The most digital advanced screen can't preserve that interplay I just described. And so especially nowadays when we communicate mostly via Facebook and text, I think it's important to remember that, or not to forget, actually, that this energy, this connection that we have, to make sure that it's not lost. So in auditions and everyday activities, that terrible feeling of, I hope they like me, like, do they like me? Like, how can I change if they like me? And instead, you know, I had to think, like, how can I expand? How can I fill this room just being me? How can I be back? And so it's this that is continuous, that's limitless, that's timeless.
Go out, I am all alone. All the trees outside are buried in the snow. I spend my night dancing with my own shadow, and it holds me, and it never lets me. I move slow and steady, but I feel like a waterfall. Yeah, I move slow and steady past the ones that I used to. on, oh.